If these Hulkaminum Coast Salish ancestors could speak to us today, they would tell us remarkable stories of their way of life before the coming of the Europeans. A new book titled Two Houses Half Buried in Sand by Salt Spring Islander Chris Arnett helps give voice to the oral traditions of British Columbia's Coast Salish people. The book also recalls the friendship between the white woman and the native woman, who understood the importance of resurrecting these stories from the sands of time.
Well, the women you're referring to are Beryl, Mildred Cryer, and her close friend, mentor, Mary Rice, whose Indian name was Hullanamut.
In the early part of the 20th century in Chemainn, she was the village washerwoman. She was also the village midwife, and she delivered hundreds, thousands of babies during her lifetime. She was also a healer and a thisa, which is a woman who can see events in the future and events in the past. She was a recognized authority on the traditions of her tribe. This is a photo taken by Beryl Cryer of Mary Rice in wearing the shmakwalsh, which is a blanket made of mountain goat wool. And this is only worn by the high-ranking people. One of the most significant things about these stories from an anthropological point of view is that they're based from the perspective of a woman. Like, there were a lot of male anthropologists working in this area during the 30s, and a lot of them said, oh, the old culture's dead, you know, we'll be lucky if we can grab any kind of remnants. And they worked exclusively with male informants, whereas the majority of the stories Beryl Cryer collected are from the female perspective. They're collected from female informants, and they give a view of a woman's experience as a Coast Salish woman.
These stories are important for youth today, native and non-native, because these are ancient stories. And like the elders have told me, how could we have survived without them?
Many of the stories in the book give references to the village of Penelakut on Cooper Island, pictured here in 1983 with Longhouse still standing. There are also references to people and places on Salt Spring Island.